Let's talk beer. When we think about beer, we think about Bud Light, Budweiser, Coors Light, all those big guys with the crazy commercials, whether it's Keeping the Mountains Blue or Clydesdale's delivering a nice fresh beer. And in retrospect, beer's been around for a long time. And I'm not talking 100 years, I'm talking tens of thousands of years. I'm talking the Mesopotamian era, where they were frat boys before Zac Efron made it look cool.
Are you talking to me?
You jump to the Egyptians, they were doing the same thing. You jump to the Greeks and Romans, they weren't drinking fine wine, that was just for a fancy painting. They were drinking beer. Now jump to the 1900s, Prohibition's in effect. Beer comes to a sudden halt. They were literally drinking underneath the table. And that doesn't mean drinking more than the guy next to you. They were literally drinking underneath the table. Now jump 15 years, we're back in business. We're canning beer now. Jump another 20 years and now you're bringing back the Bud Lights, the Coors Lights, the Budweisers, and all those crazy commercials that you can drink their own beer. What? But what about craft beer? Craft beer is fairly new. Craft beer is coming from a local brewery supported in a local town or city. So what's their struggle? Why aren't they so popular? Well, they're dealing with the big guys. Well, they had to start from somewhere, right? So I was able to sit down at Greenport Brewery to learn what's so special about craft beer and what's so special about supporting a local brewery and how it came about. Here's their story.
I am John Leachy.
And I'm Rich Vandenberg.
My name's Duffy Griffiths. I'm Director of Brewing Operations here at Greenport Harbor.
I'm Patrick Alford. I'm the head brewer here at Greenport Harbor Brewing.
Hey, what's up, guys? My name's Mike Rizzo. I'm a brewer here at Greenport Harbor Brewing.
Hi, my name's Grace Morales. I work in the kitchen.
Hi. Welcome to Greenport Brewing. So Greenport is actually coming up on its 9th anniversary. It started as an idea a bit longer ago than that. It was something we'd been talking about over a few beers in a backyard, and luckily Rich was able to secure a location down in our original spot in Greenport.
Yeah, an old firehouse that we basically renovated ourselves, spent weekends and school holidays doing it. Very understanding wives and families at home that kind of indulged us in this little fun project that we started out with. Didn't realize it would take off like it did. Quickly grew to a point where we were not able to make enough beer out of that location, so we had to start to look around and make the decision whether or not we wanted to contract brew or if we wanted to make sure that we brewed every ounce of our beer ourselves, which we felt like was the more appropriate thing for us to do in our minds. Maybe not necessarily the smartest business decision, but that's what we did, so we found Bacalles.
Yeah, so Bacalles, once we moved into this space, or secured this space, we thought we were geniuses getting the first one open, and this would be just as easy, and it ended up being probably the toughest couple of years, you know, of our lives. And a big part of that was, you know, securing funds, not easy. Working with the town, challenging, you know, as far as building out the space, and really just kind of having that extra bit of energy to push it through. And I think, you know, when we are at our best, we basically are self-starters and do things on our own. And I think we got it done as a result of that. So
yeah, with a lot of help from some, you know, great fans and friends that ultimately, you know, agreed to step up and help finance the actual acquisition and the build out, and we couldn't have done it without them as well. So, you know, that's all part of the, I think, the real core strength of the core of being local for us.
I'm gonna throw back a couple and keep them glued to my right hand, any flavor, size, or brand, until the point where I can't stand. No, nothing picks me up like a beer can. Well, I woke up at 1 p.m. and introduced myself to my new girlfriend. And there's a wrecking ball size hole in the wall in the basement. I ain't got no clue how or who could have made it. a plan. I'm gonna throw back a couple and keep them glued to my right hand. Any flavor, size, or brand, until the point where I can't stand. No, nothing picks me up like a beer can.
I love the shop for the experiences. Being out here, we're local to a lot of farmers and winemakers, and it makes making beer around here really fun.
I really like working here. It's great being a part of the North Fork community. There's a lot of great people doing a lot of great things out here. Just proud to be part of it.
And I love working here because I love the environment and the people.
I love working here because, you know, we're always playing around with recipes, throwing different things. And then when you go out to eat at night, you see the beer on tap at your local places, which is the coolest thing.
Keep them glued to my right hand. Any flavor, size, or brand, till the point where I can't stand. No, nothing picks me up like a beer can.